Hey, welcome to another episode of What's Up in Photography. Today's session is going to be on fixing white seamless backgrounds. I've opened the image up in Photoshop, and you can see it's quite evident now that the left side of the image needs some fixing. And also, with my high key shots, I usually like a white background. For whatever reason, maybe one of the lights didn't fire off properly. It's a little brighter on the right side, a little darker on the left, and we're going to make that all uniform. I'm going to do this very quickly. If I had more time, it would be a little bit of a cleaner process. There are other options you can do too. You can separate the model from the background and just put her on top of a white layer. You can do that too as well, but for the purposes of today, I'm just going to show you how to quickly edit the seamless background. Next, we're going to duplicate the layer. There's a couple ways you can do that. You can use Command J on the Mac, or you can go to the Layers menu in Photoshop and go Duplicate the Layer. The reason being is I don't want to do any destructive things to the original image. By using Layers, if we make a mistake, we can always come back and delete the layer or do something without harming the original image. After drawing the marquee, with the marquee tool and actually drawing a small thin rectangular shape, we'll then grab Control T, which is the transform tool, and drag the left side of the marquee tool to the left. And we have now corrected the messiness on the left side of the image without having to use the clone tool and do all sorts of things. On the bottom of the layers palette, we'll go to create new adjustment layer, which is the round circle in the middle of all the icons, and then we'll select levels. The next phase is we'll grab the slider and slide the slider to the left, which will basically look like we're overexposing the whole image. Don't worry, again, we're on a layer using an adjustment layer. The next phase is now we'll use Command I to invert the mask, which now has hidden all the adjustments we've made. We'll grab the brush tool, make sure the brush is selected at white, and then we'll just start painting on the background. And you can see everything, the background's getting very white now. Again, this is your earlier stages and we're doing this quickly. But you don't want to touch the model with the brush tool. The idea is you just want to lighten up the background. As you can see, the background is slowly becoming white. We're cleaning up all along the edges, around her hair, around her top, and you can see gradually the background is getting whiter. This is a step that if it doesn't come through in the first wave, then usually what I do is I duplicate it and do it again. So I'll compress the layer and basically start the process again till eventually I get a nice clean white background. And you can see again the image is getting brighter. I'll go back to the layer again, go Command I to conceal what we've just done, and then again grab the brush tool, grab white, and again start painting white again. And you can see gradually the background is becoming whiter, like if we had properly exposed the background with proper studio lighting, and presto, we're getting a nice clean white background, which is a common problem I see in a lot of images where the tonal value of the white is not all the way across. The next thing is to see where we may have missed with our brushing. We can actually hit the backward slash on our keyboard and the image will appear in red. So what we want to do is we want to remove the red spots off the background, because those are areas that we haven't hit with our brush. Again, the model must stay in red because we're not trying to expose her. We're assuming she's perfectly exposed. I know in this example she isn't, but we're just working on the background currently. Well, I hope you enjoyed this segment. Again, this is a quick touch-up session on how to get your background nice and clean, without having to use the clone tool, and just bringing the whiteness back in the image with just a few simple techniques. This is a great technique. Again, there are alternatives. There's many ways to do this in Photoshop. Another thing that I've done in a lot of cases, if the background is just far too messy and too much effort, I will select her off the background and then just drop her onto a brand new white background that I've created in Photoshop. There are many ways to do this. Hope you enjoyed this segment. Please subscribe to our channel. We're trying to put as many videos out every week or so. Hope you enjoyed it, and please give us any likes or comments. Thank you. Look forward to the next video. Have a great day.